A special thanks to Proton 3S Center, MBF, SAG Auto, Snemerhat.
And what is up my beautiful peeps? Welcome back to my channel, JR here. Vanakam, ni hao. Selamat datang ke channel aku. Look what I got. Proton X50, two-tone color, flagship model, easy to identify. Now, why do I want to do more videos about this car? This car has been 1 year old plus.
You are right this time. It is over a year old by today.
Now, as you guys saw the video title, I'm going to let you guys in on why when you are considering the X50, you should consider both the highest range, the premium and this two-tone body color flagship model. Number one, I'm just going to get this right out of the way first because of the price differences. Well, this one is an edition, 11,000 edition on top of your premium range. If you guys are considering a premium, this is another 11,000 add on. But is your price well worth it for getting the 11,000 every single cent? Because this one comes with, well, two-tone, panoramic sunroof, full safety specs. Yeah, you guys can see here. Full safety specs including auto drive, which you don't get on your premium range. And also, rain sensing wipers, you don't get it on your premium. And also, this auto dimming feature on the rear view mirror, only available on the flagship. And this engine is more power, more torquey and more PS. And also it is direct injection. I don't know what that means, but this one has a more powerful engine compared to the premium. Yes, you are, I would say, getting your money's well worth when you're getting the flagship model. But JR, these are all the nice things that you get for the flagship. You are paying more, of course you are getting better stuff. And just now you say you want to consider both the premium and the flagship. What about the premium? To that fellow viewer, bawa bertenang, aku sekarang nak pergi ke sana, jadi jangan kancong. But if you haven't subscribed, silalah subscribe di butang merah di bawah. Thank you.
And tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, there you go, the Proton X50, the premium variant. So I'm going to start off with the key fob. As you guys can see, the key fob is no different from the flagship. Whatever you want to do on the flagship, this key fob can do as well on the premium. And obviously, in terms of looks wise, the only major differences is obviously the two-tone color and the panoramic sunroof. The top there is empty, there's no sunroof. And besides that, right, whatever you're getting in the front, as you guys can see here, is exactly the same. And as I move my way to the side, I don't know why, even the rear 18-inch alloys two-tone and also the brake disc is also available on the premium. In terms of looks wise and in terms of the nice looking rims, it is no different from the flagship. Oh my god, it's so hot, I want to die. Oh yeah, so this one is door lock and unlock, both sides on driver and also passenger. Oh, go in, fast. Okay, in the X50 premium range, exactly the same, you guys can see, digital instrument cluster, change whatever mode is going to change the display there, right? 10-inch, oh my god, the aircon is, oh my god, chill. So this is the 10-inch infotainment system, but it doesn't come with Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, same as the flagship. But look at the looks and the design of the interior. It is exactly the same as the flagship. You are not skimping on the interior looks. Look at it. This one also has the nice teeth, this brush here, and this one also soft opening, exactly the same as the flagship. Everything else is the same as the flagship. There is no difference. But there is one. This top part here, there are several buttons missing, obviously, because it doesn't come with the sunroof. And also this one, as I mentioned just now, this one doesn't come with the auto dimming feature. And this one also doesn't have that sunglasses holder, which you would get on the flagship. And let me just check for this. See, this one also doesn't come with that LED lights niceties on the flagship. Other than that, it is exactly the same. Okay, heading to the rear, there is little bit of difference. You see, you even get the USB ports, aircon, and the large storage as the flagship. That one difference is this. This one doesn't come with the sunroof, so it puts the light in the middle. Whereas for the flagship, it comes with the light here, LED bulbs. This one don't have, but you still get the tetaric hooks. I don't call it tetaric, so you don't put tetaric so high, right? And also another additional hook there for whatever reason. Other than that, even the armrest, 6044, Napa leather, nice. It's the same as the flagship.
JR kau bagi tahu feature-feature ada yang dekat premium dan lepas tu kau bagi pula feature yang dekat flagship. Mana ada bagi tahu beza antara ni dengan tu dan kenapa nak consider both flagship dengan premium? Kau tipu eh. And to that viewer, commenter and subscriber, thank you for your comment. But if I don't give you guys and show you guys the differences between the two models, how are you able to picture what I'm about to explain to you? Well, you see, there is actually two points that you might need to consider when you're getting this S50 and between the premium and the flagship. Number one, the price. Obviously, this one is additional 11,000. Mind you, 11,000 is 10% the price of the premium. So you think about it, do I really need all the niceties of the flagship? And if you don't need, you can go for the premium. And if you really need all the niceties, fork out the extra money and get the flagship. And with that said, point number two is the waiting time of this car. Yes, if you already not know and you've been living under the cave, this car is selling like hotcakes. I think hotcakes understatement. It's like, you know, once upon a time ago, bubble tea is the hot news every day, everywhere it's been queuing. Yup, it's like that for this car. And with that said, you might need to consider whether can you wait for the specific model that you are looking for. Because why? So I've heard, if let's say you are going for the premium and you're looking for, I don't know, the silver color, but upon when you're ordering or placing your booking and accidentally the salesman says, hey, actually, but if you're going for that color, actually the blue color may get a little bit faster. I don't know, maybe 2 months, maybe 3 months faster than, let's say, the silver color that you're getting. So would you want to get that color? That is within your consideration. Or maybe you are actually in the market for the premium. But then again, when you heard the salesman says, hey, but if you're getting the premium, you might need to wait 4 months. But accidentally, there is a flagship, maybe in 2 months can get. Do you want to get the flagship? But of course, the additional price tag that you're paying for, would you want to get it? So yes, that is the dilemma of currently this hot selling kit of X50. So to summarize it, it's the point whether can you wait for the car as fast as possible for the model that you're getting. So if you actually just want the car and you don't mind and you have the budget within the premium and the flagship, just consider both, as I mentioned in my video, between the two, and just take the car. The car is magnificent. And ladies and gentlemen, ton ton the pom pom, that is all I have for you for this video. And if you guys like my content, do give me a... And I will see you guys in my next video. Ciao! And what is up? What is up, my beautiful peeps? How am I able to picture? How am I able to describe myself?